quiz. Sign up today.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome all to another excellent edition of the Power Trading Hour. It doesn't matter whether you're on the Isle of Capri or walking down the beaches of Waikiki. We like to see you at this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
So, what do we have? Mr. Fed is... left the building, not so much. He's actually coming back here in another 23 minutes to do his little dance on the catwalk, So we'll find out a little bit more. Kind of a soft meeting announcement so far. Not a lot of movement. I don't know what else you can say. I've been waiting for the other shoe to drop. In bonds, as I said, I continue to think that we're just going to wake up one morning and see it jump right through about 154 on TLT and down below. Now, whether or not it can hold that, another story, but I suspect that's the way that the market's been moving. So we'll see how that continues to move the rest of the day. Aren't we around 156.58 is the low of the day. So we'll see whether or not that can hold. Market just seems kind of just drained, tired, a great deal of that. We were about 157.80 prior to the announcement, 156.76 now on the TLT. So that's a 10 and 20-year bond kind of composite. So that's it. And, of course, generally you have pretty light volume on a day like this, so there's not a lot to read into it. Let's see what we have here now. I'm going to call it about 900 million shares on the lighter on the CBOE consolidated ticker website. So lighter volume, kind of pushing a little higher. Volume has been less each time we've gotten up to this level in the S&P cash at that 3,700 level, and pretty much been fairly light. Anyway, we'll watch what happens. You tend to get a little up and down over the next hour. Of course, what am I going to say? Maybe 3:15 Eastern, 3:30 Eastern. Generally, that's the window when they're done asking questions and the market can move on without waiting for somebody to drop the baby Ruth in the punch bowl and maybe move the markets a great deal more than anybody thinks. So what else do we have out there? Well, we can just go to the markets themselves and take a look. But basically flat on the S&P, a rounding error in the decimal points. Dow's down 97. That actually... I think it was about down 50 prior to the announcement. NASDAQ's been up in the plus 50s most of the day, now up plus 19. Russell's been down pretty much all the day. Crude oil's been up about 18 cents. And kind of interesting that it's up and that gasoline has been the stashes of gasoline, the reserves of gasoline has been up five straight weeks. So you have to worry that is going to back up into the price of crude. Gold, as we said, up 0.2%, not much going on there, although it was up about 20 bucks, 22 bucks earlier, if I remember, pre-market. So we got a kind of quiet market waiting for the Fed to finish up their little walk on the catwalk. And if you don't know, what's that? Twice Said Fred, Something Said Fred, Fred Something, sang that song. They do the little dance on the catwalk. That's about it. And kind of interesting, I don't know who started this effort to talk and not say anything, and the market actually pay attention like it means something. But I don't know. We're going on 20 years with this to do it. I'm just too sexy for my shirt. Yes, I know. Thank you for the private messages. So that's kind of it. Let's do a little history, and then we'll move into charts. Okay. What do we want to do? We want to do history.
Then it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
On this day in 1950, in the wake of massive Chinese intervention in the Korean War, President Henry Truman declares a state of emergency, proclaiming that communist imperialism threatens the world's people. Truman called upon the American people to help construct an arsenal of freedom. In November, the stakes of the Korean War dramatically escalated with the intervention of hundreds of thousands of communist troops. Prior to their arrival on the battlefield, the U.S. forces seemed on the verge of victory in Korea, just days after General Douglas MacArthur declared an end to the war offensive. However, massive elements of the Chinese army smashed into the American lines and drove the U.S. forces back. Of course, a bitter winter. And all for the sake of having a show called MASH, I suspect. That's what this whole thing was about, right? Because it seemed to be one of those undeclared wars. So it wasn't quite a war. No one made any big deal about it. But maybe that's just me. Okay, let's go on to bigger and better things today. As we said, time to look at some charts and other things. Oh, I did want to get to a few things, and that was, again, my sit rep. Euphoria remains supreme. No one can believe that market's going to go lower. We're kind of newsbound. Maybe something else will come out. You never know. Vapor for volume over the last few days, but no surprise. Couldn't go down, can't go up. Extremely low short interest continues, although we did have a little bit of a spike yesterday in the put call out of the money puts. And, of course, the FOMC today remains on stage till about 3:15 and 3:30, so we can forget it like yesterday's newspaper and put it in the bottom of the birdcage, and that's about it. So, as I said, time to go on to bigger and better stuff. We'll look at some charts today and some moves. Wanted to get into where is it? Oh, actually did some other stuff. We'll look at some other stuff when we come back. But I don't think that's about it. Kind of a light move down. Don't think anything's really going to matter until after they quit talking at about 3:15. But we'll look and see what's happened so far in the market. And got a question already, so we'll answer it when we come back. And that is, buying stocks have fallen in the last couple of days. Talk about at least what normal is in the market when we return.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. Do you have broken or unwanted jewelry, diamonds, watches, coins, silverware, and other collectibles that you would like to turn into cash? Tiger Precious Metals and Stones will pay fair market value. We make it easy to turn your precious metals that are sitting around in your house into cash. Call Andy now at 727-329-8245, and he will walk you through our safe and secure process. Andy has been in the business buying and selling precious metals for over 15 years. Call Andy now at 727-329-8245.
TFNN has just launched our Tiger Dollar Holiday Sale. For a limited time, we've doubled all the Tiger Dollar bonuses where you can now get up to a 20, 30, or even a 40% bonus on your Tiger Dollar purchase. Tiger Dollars are good for all TFNN newsletters, webinars, and services and never expire. Whether you're a current subscriber or just thinking of signing up for any TFNN products in the future, this is a great time to get your Tiger Dollars. Happy holidays from all of us at TFNN.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
And we continue to be kind of weak here, down 2.5 points on the S&P. Dow's down 103. The way it's been kind of acting, I think it wants to go down there and check out its little friends down there at 30,000, maybe take off that 30,000 party yet. This seems the weaker of the bunch, but you never know what they're going to say. It could go higher, could go lower, but certainly just kind of drifting lower at the moment. NASDAQ been losing a little bit, tick by tick, set up 17. And that's about it. Gold's basically flat, down 50 cents. So I'll keep an eye on all those to see how the market's reacting to Right Said Fred. Okay, got a lot of new stuff to look at here. So let's see if we can't go through as much as we can. First of all, we'll see if how many stocks out here really doing anything to the downside. Let's clean this up a little bit. Advil Pharmaceuticals, AVDL, doing a little bit of dark cloud cover. Not the perfect example, but interesting. Chemo Sentry, some dark cloud cover, these biotechs. Curtis? No. So I don't know what that one is. Disc Network, falling out of bed a little bit, back down to support at $32. One of the bigger percent decliners of the day. GBT, Global Blood Therapeutics, just kind of reversing what it did yesterday. GoGo, this one I always wonder if it will be around in a year. They do satellite internet to airplanes. And I think their days are numbered, but it's hard to tell. INOV, down a tick to retest the low 1972, or at least it's headed that way. That's a Novalon Holdings. INSM, a huge move lower. And as Tom likes to say, if you were long and you were long back here on the 17th of November, you're in a losing position. INSMED, INSM, kind of a big bad day for those folks. if you're long, I guess. In VAX, down a little bit, that's Novamax. Ocule. Pretty kind of ugly candle on this one in the biotech, O-C-U-L. Went up to 24.30, reversed it all, lower than yesterday. And if it continues on, maybe lower than the day before. S-Y-R-S, and just a little bit of a retracement. T-B-I-O, this is another one that fell out of bed today. Translate Bio, I don't know if there was news on it, but it went right up to resistance levels. The last high at 28.09 had almost 10 million shares. The one yesterday had 1.3 million shares. Not a real surprise that this thing ripped back down to the downside. And currently, 24 hours ago, it was 28.04. Today, it is 22.78. That's the problem with the light volume tests of previous highs. Verisite, another one. This has been kind of moving lower. But certainly broke the 3x3 displaced moving average about 5 days ago and has been on the sell side ever since. And Vivo, V-I-V-O, I wouldn't say it's a big deal, just a lot more of what we've seen the last few days. Viridian Biosciences. So let's go to percent advancers on the day, and that's Cala. Calithera Biosciences, big move up to $6.19, he said. CLLS, just kind of a reversal of yesterday's bad news. CYRX, CryptoPort, I don't know if there's that much in that one. EH, just a small bounce out of a decline. EHANGS Holdings. HTBX, penny stock. Heat Biologics bouncing off the $5 level. Mara, this is Marathon Patent Group, big shooting star. I think this is in the Bitcoin space. What you don't want to do is see this thing gap down tomorrow in equal way. That would be one of the nastiest shooting stars of all time. MGTI, which is a little move up on MoneyGram. I don't know why this thing would have such huge swings. Got to think that for Christmas, a lot of people send money around. MSTR, Monster, or MicroStrategy, excuse me, did pop up a bit today, still keeping the gap. Volume's okay on it. PTGX, a little bit of a reversal, but not much. And Protagonist Therapeutics, PTGX, the symbol on it. RDFN. Redfin, nice move higher today, 71.76, no stop, a little lighter volume, but probably to be figured out. I don't know what, I'm going to have to find out more about that stock. STRL, and that's up to $20.69, Sterling Construction. Volume's okay on that. VUSI. A continuation of a breakout from yesterday on volume of the previous highs. Had about 10 million shares on the previous $5.31 high about 60 days ago. It's went through that with about the same volume yesterday. Volume a little lighter today, got up at 562 on the breakout. WB Weibo, a nice move today, not much in the way of volume. So far, about the same as yesterday. You did get up to this gap at $44. Workday, still in the trading range, but a nice move. Volume a little light, but probably most everything is going to be a little bit light today. We're going to take a quick stroll through the 52-week highs, see if we see anything other than massive blow-off tops like we saw in Aclaris Therapeutics today. It's got to 669. It's back almost $5. Not a big volume stock out there. You had a lot of volume, but it just looks like it's trying to hold the previous high of $5.04 going back to, October 9th. To Acoustics Technologies, AKTS, That looks like a breakout. Volume is not too bad. You wanted about 3 million shares, though, and that's about a million shares today. APPS, Digital Turbine. These guys are cranking out some power, but no volume. $50.20, about 2.7 million shares. You wanted about 4, maybe 4.5 million shares. ATVI, Activision Blizzard, up on very light volume, testing the previous high of 87.73 that had 16 million shares with 4 million shares so far. Got a lot to run through here while we're waiting for Mr. Fed to get out on stage. That's just too sexy for the current interest.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And start off this segment. We've got pretty much exactly what everybody thought. Oh, he's speaking now. Jimmy in the den wants to know whether or not he will drop the chalupa as he speaks here for the next 45 minutes.
Sir, drop the chalupa. Put it down and back away. Sir, don't be silly. Drop the chalupa. I said, drop the chalupa.
Put it down, man.
Yeah, drop the chalupa.
Well, I don't know if he's going to drop the chalupa at all, but we can move on. Question during the break was whether or not Activision Blizzard was making a high here. And what can you say? The biggest problem with the game companies this year is that AMD and NVIDIA can't supply the video cards to ride to drive a lot of these new games. If you just go to any of the websites like Newegg or anything else, all you see is out of stock, out of stock, out of stock. There was some discussion last week that there would be enough stock this week that they were all going to try to get it into the country, but I see no evidence of that yet. So maybe they'll do better in the first quarter. Generally, they break out this time of year. But the big games that really need a lot of video power, Microsoft Flight Simulator, the new version 2020, is one that can use any amount of video cards you can buy. In fact, kind of playable with about a $1,500 video card right now, the 3090. But, of course, that card is totally unavailable. And then some of the other games are held up by not being able to get joysticks and other stuff. I think it's Star Wars something or other, universe. Anyway, it's kind of like a flying game where you fly around and shoot other folks in all the little space vehicles. And, of course, it acts like it's in air, although it's in outer space. I don't understand that at all. They're teaching all our young some very bad ideas about how space actually works. But that being said, the shortage of video cards with some of the best new games and the shortage of joysticks has been highly problematic for the game companies this year. Baidu, one of the bigger ones, looks to me like maybe a blow off top to 201.11 today. I've not been a fan. I know that there's a lot of money to be made in these. But the question is whether or not on the stage door exit stage left, we have a president actually say that Chinese stocks have to get the same rules applied to them as U.S. stocks. I suspect before anything happens on the 20th of January, that does come down. And we're going to see that whether or not the Chinese will open their books for the rest of the world to look at. So I'd be very worried about any Chinese stocks going ahead in the next 30 days, more than the rest of the market. Maybe that's what tips everybody off. David's tea, it's not my tea. Up to $2.95 today, back down to about $2.40. So kind of a nice blow off, huge volume on that. Etsy, nice move, although it opened higher or lower, excuse me, from yesterday. Still trying to push on it, but looks like a lot of volume. One of the other ones breaking above, kind of the same thing, is Turtle Beach. These guys make headsets for gamers. And again, it'd be a much better Christmas if the video cards and the joysticks would show up. So maybe they still do. This one broke higher today, 26.13, pretty much rolling it all back already today. HTBX, which is Heat Biologics. I think we brought this up in another scan. Just going back up to resistance. So I don't think much going on in that. ICLN, BlackRock Institutional Clean Energy. Just hanging out there at the highs. IDRA tried to touch, this is IDRA Pharmaceuticals, touched the $5.37 high, went to $5.50, gave it all back up today. So these are not positive moves. Got a little bit of a reversal, maybe some dark cloud cover on Kratos Defense. That's KTOS. Liberty Global. Just a peak above the previous highs of the last week or so, not holding it to 25.55, back down to about 25.20, it looks like. We talked about Mara already once, Marathon Patent Group. Watch out for a gap lower tomorrow, not predicting it, But that would make one of the most identifiable shooting stars in a long time that I've seen. Mattel, I think, do they, maybe somebody in the den knows, do these guys have the Baby Yoda thing going for them? Because that seems like the hottest toy again this year after last year. But good volume yesterday, about half that volume today as it got to 1789. MITK, My Tech Systems, broke above the $15 level yesterday with a gap and decent volume. Went to a higher high, 1658, pulled back into yesterday's candle. Decent volume. Mankind, MNKD. Two N's, huh? Mankind, MNKD. Huge, nice candle today. Can't say anything bad about that. You would have liked to seen some, maybe a little more volume, but on a bad volume day, not that much. Match Group, of course, Grindr and all those other kind of matching, what do you call them? Very social network. I think that's what I'd call it. MTCH, a little gap higher, volume's okay. MTAP, NetApp, gap higher with nothing. But we'll see what the end of the day comes in. We talked about this Ocular Therapeutics, fairly dark cloud cover depending on how the day ends up. Penn National Gaming, just creeping above previous highs. 76.72 takes you back to the high of September 18th. That had 27 million shares. Yesterday, as you broke through it, 5 million shares. Today, about 3.2 million shares. So, man, it looks like a dubious break of the highs. PayPal Holdings, nice gap higher. Volume's okay. That's it. Okay. QQQs, they've been going higher on nothing for a while. Today it is going to be yet another day. Looking for 50 million shares or better. You got about 14.6 million shares in the queues. Maybe you get it tomorrow or something else, but looking fairly weak. Redfin, what do these guys do that the other guys don't do? Come on, get out of there. Operates a real estate brokerage company in the United States. Includes assisting individuals purchase and sell a home. They must be somewhere else other than Redfin Corporation, incorporated in 2002, Seattle, Washington. Okay. We shall be back in a moment.
Hi, folks, this is Tom O'Brien. Are you looking to buy or sell gold, silver, platinum, coins, or bullion? We can help. At Tiger Precious Metals and Stones, we specialize in the buying and selling of gold, silver, as well as collectible U.S. and foreign coins. We not only buy your unwanted or broken jewelry, but you can trade that in for gold and silver coins, too. Call Andy now at 727-329-8245 for a quote over the phone and to lock in the current market price. Call us now at 727-329-8245.
TFNN has just launched our Tiger Dollar Holiday Sale. For a limited time, we've doubled all the Tiger Dollar bonuses where you can now get up to a 20, 30, or even a 40% bonus on your Tiger Dollar purchase. Tiger Dollars are good for all TFNN newsletters, webinars, and services and never expire. Whether you're a current subscriber or just thinking of signing up for any TFNN products in the future, this is a great time to get your Tiger Dollars. Happy holidays from all of us at TFNN.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
SLM making a new high briefly, but pulling back into the trading range, so not much going on there. A little bounce, so maybe Powell found a little bit of salve to put on the boo-boo of the market, and up 9 points on the S&P cash. Dow's still down 13, NASDAQ's up 62, so that looked a little bit better. Gold's off $4. Again, you get a lot of machinations. I like that word. You don't get to say machinations enough every day. Anyway, SLM making a tiny new high, but pulling back in on no volume. I'm just wondering how well that goes forward, making loans for school educations. But we shall see. Spiro Therapeutics, no Agnew apparently. Nice poke to 1940 today, kind of almost back into the trading range. Decent volume, though. STRL, which is Sterling Construction, $20.69, about half the volume of the couple of days ago when it did have a nice move, but no real look at this falling back in. Seagate Technology continues to just really crawl higher on lower volume over the last, you know, you basically can say, back to 1st of November, this thing has been losing a little bit of volume each day as it continues to move higher. You've got another kind of doji forming today, about half the volume. Team, T-E-A-M, nice move higher. Volume's okay. It's not great, but doesn't look like that's in any danger of pulling back so far today. Teradyne. What do we have here? And just spinning. Did get to us just a couple pennies high of yesterday. TER's a symbol, 120.84 compared to 120.76 yesterday, but back into the trading range with not a lot of juice. TGTX, TG Therapeutics, another biotech up on very light volume compared to yesterday, 2.3 million shares yesterday to 2.6 today. VUSI, I like that symbol. Seems cheery. Well, certainly the reaction to something out here is cheery. Got to a new high of $6.52, pretty close to holding that high. Volume was very good yesterday, got about half that today, but still pretty strong for the last 2 or 3 weeks as this has broken out above the $5.40 range. So that gets that list done. Did we do this one? I don't think so. They're not Mitch on the 52-week low range. But Galapagos ADR, GLPG. Let's find out what these guys do. certainly did drop the chalupa. It's a clinical stage biotechnology company. Don't know what they did. Don't see the news here. But it wasn't good. 120 to under 100. So a 20% haircut. MTI, Rockwell Medical. I don't know how that's a 52-week low. Got it. S-A-T-S. This certainly looks like it. EchoStar, S-A-T-S. Find out about this one. $20.33 is the low. Broadband satellite technology. Well, this makes a lot of sense. I hadn't thought about this one in a long time. Hughes and EchoStar. Starlink from SpaceX, how do these guys continue on? I think it's very problematic, but certainly looks like a business destined for the ash heaps. To provide stall gateways, terminal equipment for other satellite systems. Well, certainly looks like I can imagine a lot of the business going to SpaceX if it's really going to be about $80 or $100 a month. Could be extremely cheap for these other companies. And of course, the big problem with HughesNet and all the other stuff that's been around forever is the incredible thin bandwidth that you get. And I think we're talking about in the megabytes a day, not in the gigabytes per day, being able to get any kind of stuff. And of course, the lag, the latency of being about half a second to a second compared to actually having about maybe a little bit more, about 100 milliseconds of latency. So maybe about 10 times faster handing packets back and forth. But it looks like a lot of volume out here in the last few days. So maybe a good thing to check out this weekend. And that wraps up the standard scans. That's up to 10. 3704. Just checked real quick. I don't see anything out of the trading range. Questions, anything going on in the fangs? We'll take a look. I know that Google got another lawsuit today. We'll look at them in a minute. Up on not much in the way of volume. Resistance is going to come probably another $25 higher and into the December 1st high. That was $32.48.95 for Amazon. You need about 4.5 million shares. You got about 2.8 million shares going into that candle. And of course, if you compare it to the down volume of 7.2 million shares back on the 9th of November, as you go through this level of what should be resistance. Other things going on, Netflix, NFLX. Just back up to the resistance level that is this gap down from the 21st of December. I think that was on earnings. And you had 17 million shares down. You got about 6 million on the upside on the strongest day. MSFT. Nice move higher to 219.96 today for the high. Volume's okay. It's not all that great. I don't suspect this does a lot up or down before the end of the year. Apple. Just up against, as we said yesterday, very stiff resistance, a gap down from the 3rd of September at 257 million shares. Let's call it 258 million shares, up with about 158 million shares yesterday. Today, just 63 million shares, slightly higher high. If it wasn't Christmas, you would say that this would be a fairly good indication of a high. A lot of discussion out here today pushing the stimulus will all go to Apple and the Apple makers. They did move. I don't know. I don't think we talked about it. They did move their manufacturing to India. And promptly, the people that owned that factory didn't pay any of the employees. And they started throwing Molotov cocktails at the building. Apparently a little bit damaged. don't think that's really made it to the front page above the fold of the newspapers in the United States. Kind of interesting that you are getting it tiny. And into the frying pan.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by, as well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and to help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And we're in the final stretch of the Power Trading Hour. And we're up 12 points on the S&P Cash. Again, everybody just looking forward to when he quits speaking. I don't think anybody's suspecting much in the way of earth-shattering news in the next 15, 30 minutes that he's probably going to answer questions. But we shall see. It's just kind of a quiet day. When they get done, the market's all going to it kind of reminds me of the days of the Cold War when everybody was standing around, or different people were standing around Stalin. And the CIA would all make a big deal about who was next to him and who wasn't, and who was on the outs, when maybe it meant nothing. Maybe it's just how they filed in. But everybody always wants to make something of something, even when there's not much there. As Sigmund Freud once said, sometimes a cigar is just a cigar. But anyway, we'll see how this goes out, but probably not a message to be brought out of Chairman Powell before about 3:15 or 3:30. And we get to digest whatever everybody thinks he said, who I'm sure if you ask him would probably say he didn't say it all. And half the time they have to come out a couple of days later and say, you know, I didn't say that at all. It's kind of like meaning of a song. Everybody kind of has a meaning to them themselves. If the song's written right, you know, you get to make it kind of your own by what you think it means. And that's kind of what's going on here. Anyway, as we said, Apple getting back up to fairly strong resistance levels. Kind of interesting that everybody just assumes that any big stimulus will be a boon to Apple. Last I heard, no checks going out. Certainly not going to be any checks going out soon. So we shall see at the close what the true message of Powell was. But in the meantime, sell when you can, not when you have to. And we will be here tomorrow. Same bat channel, same bat time.